Chad Myers is here. Just to explain a little bit further, how exactly did this work?
We still have the same number of pings. But what happened, what has changed now, is that those engineers at Inmarsat, they've never had to do this before.
Okay.
They didn't even know that they could. But they worked it out over the weekend that they could figure out whether the plane was flying toward their satellite or away from their satellite, even by the slightest margin, by what's called Doppler shift. So we talked to the Inmarsat guy, we talked to Chris a couple hours ago as well, and he said, yep, Doppler shift is what we use. Here's Inmarsat's satellite. Think of it on a giant flagpole in the middle of the Indian Ocean. It stays over the exact same spot all the time. It's called geosynchronous orbit, 64.5 degrees east right there. So let's get rid of this. And now let's look at what we think the pings probably look like. Remember, they haven't released the pings to us exactly, but we're pretty close here. We have where they thought the plane probably started, that's the last contact, and where it ended. Now, I haven't drawn all the pings because I want to kind of keep this a little bit simplified here, but this is the distance to the first ping, the second ping, the third, and the fourth. We knew the distances and we always did know the distance, but now what's different is, are the planes moving away, along, or outside? Inside the circle or outside the circle? That's the Doppler effect. Now let's get right to this here. I'm gonna take you to what I believe the Doppler effect is, especially for that ping right there. That's the first ping, somewhere around 2 o'clock. We say 2:11, I'm not sure this is exactly where it is, but we're within a couple hundred miles right there.
Okay.
The plane was flying into the ring, inside the ring, which means it was getting closer to the satellite itself. So this is Doppler radar. We use Doppler radar, the same word, to know this is Tuscaloosa's tornado. This is moving this way by Doppler shift. This is moving this way by Doppler shift. We know, and we knew at the time, there's a tornado on the ground right there at Tuscaloosa. Where else can you hear Doppler shift? If you hear a fire truck or a train or a race car go, vroom, vroom.
Sure, you can tell if it's far away or closer to you.
That's the shift. If you're going closer, the frequency is different than when you're moving away from you. The train moves across and it gets lower. The sound gets lower as the train goes by. So as we get rid of this and back to our satellite, because here's really where the guts of all of this comes in, this is the first ping. There's a second ping through here, a third ping down here. This ping is getting closer to the satellite. This ping, it's flying along the line, not getting closer or farther away. The ping down here, it's definitely flying away from the satellite to get it down to Australia. And the last ping here, we don't know if it was the, you know, the end of the flight or was there still another hour of fuel or 59 minutes anyway, but there was no 9/11 ping, 9/11 a.m. ping. So what Inmarsat has done is said, if all this is true, moving away, moving closer, skidding steady, there's no possible way that we can make all of that new data fit to any flight plan going this way. It had to go that way if all of these things came true. We're still only using one ping. We still don't have triangulation. I know it's all out there, but these guys worked on this all weekend. I know they did because I was part of a couple email chains going on when they're talking about Doppler shift, and they worked hard on this.